If you ever wondered how to share releases across multiple projects in Jira, you can call that cross-project releases if you want, then you came across the right video. I'm going to show you how you can create cross-project releases with the Swanly Jira plugin. And as a bonus, I'll show you the cross-project release reports that Swanly automatically generates for you, including time tracking, story points tracking, release burndown chart, and more. I'm Nikki from Jexo, the Atlassian marketplace partner that helps project and product managers and teams prioritize, plan, and track their work with our Jira apps. Before I show you how to create cross-project releases, let's first have a look at what Jira offers you out of the box in terms of release functionality. In Jira, you can create different projects, and under these projects, you can create releases and issues and link them together. This is particularly useful if you want to track what issues are being delivered in your release, and you can also track the time spent on release and so on. Now, there is a catch. You cannot link release that belongs to one project to issue from another one. Usually with smaller projects, it's not an issue because you can manage all your work in one project. But as the operation gets bigger, you get more people and teams, it often happens that we split work in many Jira projects to give teams more autonomy into running their day-to-day work. But you still have a need to track issues under the single release from across these projects. What some decide to do is to create a version in each of these projects that has the same name. This then enables you to link issues to the same version name, search your Jira issues and run reports. The tricky part is to keep these versions synchronized. The name, description, release date, or even status can change in one of the projects, and that might cause inconsistencies. If you have a small number of projects where you need to manage cross-project releases, it might not be such a big issue. But imagine keeping versions synchronized across tens of projects. Even creating them all manually will be time-consuming. And that's why I want to show you this handy plugin Swanly. Swanly is a simple project management app for Jira Cloud that also helps tackle release management in Jira, and cross-project releases are one of many functions that it brings to the table. Let me first start with creating a cross-project release. After you install the app from the Atlassian Marketplace, you can access it by clicking on the Apps menu and then Swanly. The first view that is open is the issue view, so you want to switch to the release view to manage releases. Now, when we are in the Swanly release view, to create a cross-project release, just click on Add Release button and then here on the plus button. This is a simplified create release form where you can give your release a name and select projects you need. And then just click on Create button. Now when your release is created, you can find it in the list view and you can click on the name to open the release report view. Here you can edit the release name, description, assign scope, or edit the release dates. But before I move to the cross-project release reports, let me first explain how the cross-project releases work. After you create a cross-project release in Swanly, in each project that you selected, Swanly creates a version with the same name, description, and start and end date. If we would then go and, for example, change the cross-project release name in Swanly, this change will be reflected in all these project versions too. And the synchronization works the other way as well. If we would go and change, for example, status in one of these versions in the project, then the change will be reflected in all other project versions too and in Swanly. The version attributes that get synchronized are version name, description, release start date and end date, and the release status together with archived and unarchived options. The only thing that doesn't get synchronized is when we delete version in one of the projects. In that case, only that version gets deleted and the other remains as they are. If you would like to delete the cross-project release as a whole, you need to do so from Swanly. Also, if you would like to add more projects to the cross-project release, you can simply do that from the release detail report in Swanly. Just click here on the projects field and select the extra project and click outside to save. A new Jira version is then created in the project and you can start using it. If you want to remove the project from the cross-project release, just remove the project from the field and the version in Jira will be removed too. Once you created these cross-project releases, you will definitely want to link issues to them, right? You can do that either in Swanly or in Jira directly from the issue detail. Let me first show you how you can do that from Swanly. Here, in the release detail report view, is a scope section where you can simply click on the Add Issue button and link the existing issues from the linked projects to the release. Or you can create a new issue directly from here. If you would like to link issues to the version in Jira, you can do that from Issue Detail. There is this field called Fixed Versions where you can find a release and link it to the issue. And if you are using backlog functionality in Jira, you can also assign issues to the release at bulk from here. Just drag and drop issues over to the release and you have it. So this is how Swanly allows you to synchronize releases across Jira projects. But what it also gives you are these automated release reports where you can find the full scope of the release, time tracking information and more. So let's have a look at that. You can open the release detail report by simply clicking on the release name on the roadmap or in the list view. In addition to the basic release information like release name, description, start and end date, and scope, you can also see the report section over here. These reports are split into four main categories: issue progress, time tracking, story points, and burndown chart. In the issue progress section, you can see the status categories progress of issues from all projects linked to this release. If you would like to dig a bit deeper, you can see progress based on the actual statuses of the issues from across the projects, or you can see the status category progress per project. If you are using Jira default time tracking feature, you can use this report to see the time spent on this release, the original planned estimate, and how much time is still remaining. And if you want, you can see the time tracking per project too. Similar visualization is here for story points tracking as well. You can see the overall story points progress of your release across projects, or you can switch to see progress per project. The last feature we have here is a cross-project release burndown chart, where you can see the progress of the tickets and how they are being delivered over time. This is a great place to quickly understand the progress of your release at a high level and if you are still on track to deliver on time. You can choose your burndown chart to be rendered based on the issue count, story points, or time estimate. Just a quick note. To set up a story points tracking, you just need to select your story points field in the settings over here. Afterward, all reports are generated automatically based on this field, and you don't need to limit yourself only to story points, you can select any numeric custom field that you have in Jira. Before we finish, I wanted to touch a little bit on what you can use these cross-project releases for. One of the most common use cases, of course, are software releases. But because you can run cross-project reports in Jira with releases, we also saw companies using them to track their initiatives across the projects, high-level requirements, key project phases, or milestones. It's really just up to your imagination and current need. They can represent anything, really. There are many more features that Swanly brings you in terms of release management, like, for example, release roadmap view, templates, and so on. But that's for another video. I hope you enjoyed this one. If you did, make sure you like the video, leave us a comment if you have any questions, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel.